birds singing, crickets chirping, the sound of sweet river water. Wow, what tranquility, we thought, as we rafted ahead. No sooner were we in the water than we had to brace ourselves for impact. Relax, we're just approaching our very first river rapid. We looked at each other in excitement. Our hearts kept pounding louder and louder. Lubbed up. We let go of our fears. And before we knew it, splash. Fellow Toastmasters, adventurers, and dear guests, this was my very first adventure sport, whitewater river rafting. In 2014, with my engineering friends, I had been to this town called Dandeli in Karnataka. We first travelled to Hubli by train and then went to Dandeli on road. Our train journey too was filled with fun and frolic. We started playing the game of Uno in the night. Listening to us scream and yell and absolutely go bonkers, the kid from the adjacent compartment came into ours. Looking at him standing there staring at us like this, we thought we might as well add him into the game, and we did. Guess what happened? He won the game. He just defeated all of us. So we thought to ourselves, wow, kids, they're so smart. Kids do bring joy into our lives, isn't it? So once we reached Dandeli, we stayed in an adorable two-storied red house called Stanley's Farmhouse. As we entered the compound, we saw a cycling track, a pond over there for kayaking, a scary looking turkey, an emu, a watchdog also. Now, the first activity that was decided for us was whitewater river rafting. Initially, some of us hesitated when we were told that we had to raft for 9 long kilometers. I remember asking my friend, can we just go 4.5 and come back? He said, no, you have to conquer your fears. Trust me, it's going to be fun. Better go for it. We somehow mustered the courage and geared up. Now, we traveled in a jeep from the farmhouse and we went on long, twisty, twirly roads in dense forest. And it almost felt like we were on some gigantic, mythical snake. We reached the venue and all adventurers were gathered in the line, waiting to get themselves registered for the activity. We were so excited when we went there. And I remember we paid 1100 rupees for the registration. It was later that I thought it was totally worth it. I think all of you should try whitewater river rafting. For once in your life, you should not miss it. Now there we stood by the river banks, all geared up in our life jackets and helmets. And the oars were passed on to us one by one. The instructors, the trainers, they stood there and started giving us instructions on how to raft and provided safety measures. One coach was assigned to each raft, and we were 9 people and luckily we were put into the same raft. Soon, all the rafts were being settled into the water one after the other. It was our turn to settle in. The excitement in the air was at its zenith. Now the coach told us to swim, to take the raft a little ahead, away from the banks. So we went there. Guess what he did now? He just asked us to jump into the water, just to get the feel of the river water. So some of us who knew swimming happily jumped in. We all jumped into the water and we started splashing water on each other and it went. But seeing the rest of our friends scream in fear was a sight you cannot miss. I remember my best friend Karvata. She jumped into the water and immediately she was like, she was crying and she was yelling and she just begged us to put her back into the raft. I tease her even to date, saying that, Karvi, you were hilarious that day. Soon, just like the rest of the rafts, we started moving forward. And out of nowhere, we found some water splashing on us. Some notorious person on that other raft was trying to splash water on us, you know, with the oars. So what our coach did, out of sweet revenge, he also started putting water on him from our raft. And we joined him gleefully when we started putting water. So it was literally like water holy in holy river water. Soon, we were approaching our very first river rapid. Now this was a moment I knew. Let go. We let go of our fears. From all sides, the water just splashed onto our faces. And we screamed in exhilaration. I can just remember that moment. We have a big photograph. I can just remember every moment so vividly. All of a sudden, everything became quiet. Just imagine yourself in that situation. Everything became quiet. Only the birds chirping, the cricket sounds, the splash of water. And then our coach asked us to taste the water. One sip, my friends, and I was in heaven. The water was so sweet, so pure. It felt like an elixir. Felt like I could just sip it and live forever. We took it all in. Every breath, every moment. There's absolute tranquility everywhere. Again, after some time, we were approaching yet another river rapid. And then we kept on chanting, let go, let go, let go. And before we knew it, splash. So what I experienced and what I realized from this beautiful adventure that all of us experienced was that adventure is all about letting go. It cannot be possible unless you let go. You need to let go of your fears, your inhibitions, mental blocks, your insecurities. It was because our friend encouraged us and because we decided to let go of all of these, we could enjoy. Otherwise, throughout the journey, we would have been in fear. So I believe that only when you let go, you'll be able to have any kind of adventure in your life. I believe that my next adventure is around the corner and I'm ready to let go. Are you all? Yes? Yes? Awesome. Over to conversation.